Hi guys, I'm glad you're all here. Thank you for joining me. It's been many years since I did a report about what's been going on with the sun. Of late, there's been some M-class solar flares. This one here is from the 20th. Social media has been abuzz about these solar flares. Here on spaceweatherlive.com, you can see the M-class 5.5 flare. This area of the sun, the sunspot 2929, is the one that's been pretty active lately. I even found a report talking about how ham operators have said there's been an increase in the last week in solar flares. Solar flares are rated in four different classifications. We got B, C, M, and X. X are the ones you have to worry about. M-class flares, if they're Earth-directed or we get a glancing blow, can set off alarms. We could have disruption with power. It could disrupt satellite, make satellites all confused. So these recent M-class solar flares are not the reason, if it's true, that Biden is hiding in a bunker somewhere. This weekend, we may be able to see aurora borealis, or in what they call northern lights, because of a solar flare that occurred, I believe it was the 18th. It's going to have a glancing blow to the Earth. Going through the different images on SOHO, maybe there's an asteroid coming. I don't know. Maybe if he is in his bunker, that could be why. Here we got one small asteroid. That was on the 17th. We got another sun grazer here also on the 17th. All right, here's the beginning of a solar flare. Let me step ahead a little bit. You see, it looks like it came from the area sunspot 229 or 230. And let me move ahead a little bit. Thought I saw something there. Yeah, another sun grazer. And another one. Oh, yeah, this is that larger one that I noticed. This solar flare evidently was a M1.5. And then there was another one. Let me see if I can find it. Or this might be it on the 18th. Okay, that might have been the M1.5. And then another sun grazer that went through. It had already caused a radio blackout, but on the 22nd and 23rd, they are expecting a glancing blow from the January 18th CME. Solar radiation, as observed by NOAA, GEO-16 over the past 24 hours, was above the S-scale storm level threshold. I often go by this website here. It gives me the KP index. And you can see it was a threshold all the way up to 6. I don't know if it was a little bit higher because this only goes until the 19th. And you can see here it's currently climbing again. Depending on the impact, they can affect our electrical power grid, spacecraft operation, users of radio signals, ham operators, GPS. Your satellite, maybe for television and internet. There was another burst of energy on the 19th. Let me go ahead because you won't be able to read the date. Yeah, look at that. The Carrington event in 1859 was a solar flare of an X10. Now that one made nighttime into day. People could read their newspapers at night. It set telegraph wires on fire. This is nothing compared to what happened back then. I'm just letting it run right here. That was the largest event ever recorded here on Earth in about 150 years. All right, here's today's solar event. Yeah, look how fast it shot off. Now, that flare probably came from the area named 2934, that sunspot area. And then on January 20th, there was a solar flare, a C1. And what's this one here? C1.6. So let me step this forward. This would be one of them right there. You can see all the particles. So who knows what kind of impact. Now this one did cause radio blackout. I thought this was interesting too. All right, the two solar flares that were on the 20th. Yeah, look at that one. They were almost simultaneous. Yeah, 6:24. And then the other one right after. See that? At about 9:48, a little sooner. Here's another image of today's solar flare. I'll let it play for a minute. Let it roll through again so you can see it. Gives the time there at the bottom. I wanted to show you this. This is one of the solar flares when it shot off from the side of the sun. And that little green dot, that is the Earth. So we're going to get a glancing blow. Let's let it run a little bit more. You can see it right here. And of course this other one. But this is the one looks like it's going to have a glancing blow. And that's going to be this weekend. So for the most recent alert watches and warnings, it says here for this solar flare, area of impact primarily polar towards the poles. Weak power grid fluctuations can occur or may be visible at high altitudes such as Canada and Alaska. Now there is another alert. It says continuation of a series 3189. Potential impact. Satellite systems may experience significant charging, resulting in increased risk to satellite systems. Now for the solar flare that occurred yesterday, January 20th. An enhancement in the energetic portion of the solar radiation spectrum may indicate increased biological risk to astronauts or passengers and crews in high altitudes. That's more radiation if you were flying high altitude flights. Additionally, energetic particles may represent an increased risk to all satellite systems susceptible to single event effects. Okay, X-ray class 5.5. Area of impact centered primarily on sub-solar point on the sunlit side of the Earth. Radio limited blackouts of high-frequency radio communication for tens of minutes. So that's what they're expecting to happen to us this weekend because of that M5.5 class flare. But, I don't think if he is in his bunker, he's not in the bunker because of any solar flare. More likely, he's in his bunker because he's worried about a nuclear war with Russia or China or maybe even Iran. Anyways, they're all in their bunkers and they leave us on the glowing radioactive grass while they all hide out and we're on our own. But I don't think he's in the bunker if he is in the bunker because of a solar flare. So that's all I have for you right now. Any thoughts or comments or questions? Please put it down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.